Hi there, and welcome to Exit Stage Right with Martha Sullivan. This is a show where we talk about ways to build, buy, and sell your business so you can exit stage right into your next adventure. Thank you for joining us today. I am Martha Sullivan, your host, and this is the show where we talk about ways to grow your business and make it its best and brightest self and help you achieve your financial goals along the way. So last time I talked about whether 2023 would be the year to right size your company. Very often growth is the drum that we beat every year. Gotta grow, gotta grow, gotta grow, gotta grow. And that's true. I do firmly believe that if you're not growing, you are dying. However, growth has its place. And we talked about four key drivers as to why 2023 might be a year to resize your business, right size your business to make it match or better align some of the driving forces in the market. And I discussed four of them in session 44, if you want to go back to that video and view it. Today, I want to do a little bit deeper dive into what I'm talking about relative to what it means to right size. Just how the heck would you do that? And I think there are a couple few key steps that you would want to pursue as you consider whether this is a growth year or a right size year. One, I think one of them is looking at the model that you have, your business model. Another will be focused on productivity, and there may be a third, but we'll see how the conversation goes along those lines. So let's talk about your business model first. One of the things that we talked about last week was the fact that there is an entrepreneurial characteristic that many share of eternal optimism. Of course, we're going to grow. Of course, we're going to grow. We've been growing for 3, 4 years straight at 20%. I think it's a safe bet. We're going to grow at 20% this coming year, too. And that's as deep as your analysis goes. And I would say maybe it's time to pause and reflect on that business model and why have you been growing at the rate that you have been growing? What are the dynamics going on in your market? Are your customers, is it something going on in your customers' market that is driving your volume? Or are there trends in terms of recreational activity or other business activities, political cycles? You know the various things in the market that impact your business. It's really important, I think, to take a few moments and model it out and talk it through. What was it that drove our business? So, for example, one of my clients is in the recreation business, and they were growing really well prior to the pandemic. During the pandemic, the demand for their product went off the walls to the point where they actually had to stop taking orders. They were exceeding capacity. And then coming out of the pandemic, they actually continued to grow, but the pace of the growth slowed somewhat. And so we're talking about it. We're saying, okay, so the people that didn't have your product prior to the pandemic needed it quickly, and you filled those orders. Your product is not a consumable product. That is, it lasts for a while. So it's not like I'm going to need new I'll make up a product. It's not like I'm going to need new skis next year, unless I'm really into skiing and I replace my skis on an insanely regular basis anyway. So it's that demand's going down. So the market force of everybody being forced outside to play as opposed to being forced together to play, that's changed back to pre-pandemic levels. So let's take a realistic view at what our market demand patterns may be. To me, that's one of the number one steps in considering whether you should right size your business or not. Model it out. So that's just one line in the model. That's your revenue model. Then there's the rest of the business model in terms of how are you going to build the product? How are you going, we'll stick with skis. How are you going to manufacture those skis? Can, if we were to continue to grow 20% year over year over year, do we have the facility capacity to handle that? Do we have the labor capacity to handle that? Can we get the materials? Has the supply chain issues that we were facing, have those moderated and cooled? Thinking through, if you will, the life of an order and where does that come from? Do you have what you need to fulfill that customer demand for the skis? That in that, you may detect spaces where you're going to have gaps. And filling those gaps may take some time and energy. So let's play it out. Yep, we think demand for skis is going to continue to grow 20%. Do we have the physical capacity to do it? Well, no, we'd have to expand the line and get more machines. Okay, where are we going to put the machines? Good question. We're out of space. Okay, how are we going to solve that problem? Well, we could build a new building, think 2 years, or we can rent space, think insane real estate market. What does that do to your costs? Is that 20% growth going to be as profitable as your growth now or your margins now on the level that you're at now? Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Maybe it gives you the capacity to increase your prices even more. I don't know, but that's the beauty of modeling it out in thinking it through. And how does that really play out? And do you want to do that? Do you want to build a building? Do you want to take that project on? Do you want to take that debt on? Do you want to invest in new equipment? Does it necessarily mean that some of your existing equipment needs to be replaced because it's getting worn down? All those things you want to think through, and maybe the answer is yes. Absolutely, we want to do this. We want to ride this hill all the way through, regardless of the moguls that we're navigating. We want to do this, and that's awesome. Or it may be, you know what? I don't want to do the Black Diamond Hill. I want to do the Moderate Hill. And what would that look like? And then model that out. Another way of right-sizing your company is to basically take the time and look at your areas of productivity. Are there ways that you can do more with less? So there may be aspects of the company that aren't producing. Maybe it's products that you carry. Maybe it's a business line that has seen its life cycle through and it's time to retire that business line or that product line out. So when that happens, that may give you the opportunity to redeploy resources to other areas of the company that are still growing. Or it may mean that you just take some load off and you shed the lower producing, lower performing segment and catch your breath. It's not to say you will never grow again, but you take some of the pressure off the company in that regard and really focus on improving what you have now. Another angle that I wanted to talk about is. And this came up in a family retreat that I was facilitating not too long ago. Very successful family business. They have seen really tremendous growth over the course of the second generation's ownership and leadership of the company. And they now recognize as they're getting ready to transition to third generation. That the business has grown to such a size that as their model of family members running the business and being in key leadership spots, it's gotten too big for them. And should they impose that on the next generation? As they are stepping into their leadership roles. And it's a very good question to pause and ask. That's not to say that the next generation wouldn't want the company to continue to grow or want the company to stay at its current size, but it's a good question to ask because, again, if you think about it relative to productivity, if there are segments of that business that are underperforming and that really should be retired, then maybe now is the time to retire it so that you're not passing trash, if you will, to the next generation to have to clean up. Rip off the Band-Aid and take care of it now so when the next generation steps into their roles of leadership and ownership, they're not being handed a hot mess right out of the gate. At the same time, getting the next generation ready to step into those roles is not the Vulcan mind meld. You're not just by virtue of the fact that they worked in the business all these years does not mean that they are ready to step into your shoes. Even if it looks like they're doing your job now, there are many aspects of your job. If you're in the leading gen, that they are not aware of, they don't know, and they haven't worn that mantle of responsibility on their shoulders. So it takes time to talk through those issues, matters, and build confidence and competence in the next generation, as well as in the leading generation's confidence in their competence and confidence. So that's really important. If you've got major leadership and ownership transition coming your way, taking that pause and looking at your business model and right-sizing it for 2023 makes tremendous sense. Thinking about it, what do we have the stamina to do? We talked about stamina last week, and what makes sense for where we're going. And maybe 2023 isn't going to be a growth year. It's going to be a stability year. It's going to be a right size year. It's going to be our year. So that is what I wanted to share with you today, building on session 44's discussion of is 2023 the year to right size? I hope you found that helpful. Drop me a line and let me know. As always, if you are interested in hearing more, and getting our newsletter, by all means, please take a scan of this QR code and sign up for the Providence Hill newsletter. It comes out monthly. And also visit us at thefbcg.com. That is the Family Business Consulting Group. For those of you that are family businesses, there's a treasure trove of resources there. Under the resources tab, you can see articles and newsletters, as well as events, and sign up for that newsletter. So thank you so much for joining us today. I am Martha Sullivan. This is Exit Stage Right. I've got a really good feeling about this. Go forth and transform your business today.
Kicking me out of my chair, dancing like I don't care. I've got that good.